Metano 2. Drum roll.
I started watching you guys, heard the story before. I started watching YouTube TV, didn't know anything about YouTube TV, and started watching Kwame Brown, actually. Talk about Stephen A. Smith and all of that guy. Just kind of ran across this guy that said he was telling 33 years of prison stories. And was actually sitting in the office one day and decided to write him a letter, pass him the phone, share it with the group. And so I spent the last day in there waiting with him. It's an incredible story. It's incredible information. And not only that,
they got my theme music and everything. Can y'all hear me if I don't use this mic? Can y'all hear me? First of all, it's an honor to be here. I'm thankful, I'm blessed to be here. I appreciate y'all coming out. By now, y'all already know they call me Banky Pound. A little bit about myself. In 1987, I was sentenced to two life sentences, 115 years in prison. 1987, I was sentenced to two life sentences, 115 years in prison. Let that sink in, because that's a lot of time. That's a lot of time. That's the way I felt when I got it. But I know probably the first thing come to y'all mind by looking at me, you say, ain't no way that you that old. I know y'all don't think so. I don't look that old. But trust me, I did every day of that time, 12,045 plus days. That's the equivalent to 33 years. That's how long I was incarcerated. I've only been out approximately 560 some days. So you do the math to that. The majority of my life has been spent in prison. The majority of my life. I'm actually basically really the same age as y'all as far as being out here on the street, because I've only been on the streets and society for 21 and a half years. I went in at 20, I came out a year and a half ago. So I actually been a free man for just 21 and a half years. You know, so all of that, I say all that to say this, because that came about from me making bad decisions. Bad decisions, that's what that came about for me making bad decisions. And as you get older, that's what y'all gonna figure out, did life gonna come down to that? The choices you make and the decisions. That's what it's gonna come down to. Whether you're gonna go left, whether you're gonna go right. And most of the time, that's gonna come down to where you're getting the information from. Because we only can make choices and decisions based upon the information that we got. So where you getting your information from, that's what you got to look at, the source. And if you anything like me, when I was young, I ain't listen. I was hard-headed. I listened to the dudes I was hanging around. I listened to the dudes I thought knew more than me on the corner. I listened to the streets. And that's what it got me. ain't listen to my mom. I ain't listen to my grandmother. I ain't listen to them. I listen to the streets. And that, what I'm trying to tell you is, when you get older, you think about it, you look at it and ask yourself, what sense do that make? Why would you listen to somebody that's in the same position you in? He don't know no more than you do. It may look like he do, but if he about your age, he got about the same much life experience as you got. Why wouldn't you listen to your mother? Why wouldn't you listen to your auntie, your teachers, or your coaches? People who you know got your best interest in mind. Because I guarantee you, when you get in trouble or when things go south, the people that you listening to, that's not going to be who you call. That's not going to be who you call. Your first call, your 911 call going to be to your mama. Your 911 call going to be to your mama, your grandmother, somebody that you know that's going to help you when you in trouble. Not the people that you listening to. See, that's the irony in the whole situation. We don't want to listen to the ones that's really giving us the advice because they care about us. But we won't listen to the other people. But when we get in trouble, first person we call is the ones we ain't listen to. But they always love you, so they're going to always be there for you anyway. But these are the things that we got to pay attention to, because these are the things that's going to shape our life. These are the things that's going to put our life on the course that we're going on. And these are things that I ignore. So that's why I take it upon myself to try to bring y'all this type of information now, because I don't want to see nobody go through the things I went through. I had potential. I could have did a lot more with my life, just as y'all do. Y'all in college right now, so y'all in the right place at the right stage of your life. But make no mistake about it, it can go south at any time. Like I said, I went to prison at 20. So I had enough knowledge to know what was right from wrong. But I still was hard-headed, and I still believed that I knew more than everybody else. That ain't the case. That ain't the case, man. We all got to listen to somebody. We all got to listen to somebody. That's a fact. See, when it comes down to making choices, man, it's going to come down to the point where you're going to say to yourself, this is what I believe, and this is the information that I got. But what you believe, what's fact, is two different things. See, that's your ego talk. And most of us got, well, all of us got an ego, you know. And I got an acronym for ego, man. I say that's every guy's opinion of himself. That's what you think about you. But do the world believe that that's who you are? That's what you got to ask yourself. Do the world believe that? Do you believe that? Do you believe that? That's what the coach was talking about when he was talking about, you know, pretending to be somebody else, faking, you know. One of my slogans, one of my main slogans is, don't pretend to be who you don't intend to be. Don't pretend to be who you don't intend to be, because you ain't fooling nobody but yourself. You ain't fooling nobody but yourself. When it comes down to it, man, you got to stand in that mirror and look at yourself, and you know who you are. You know who you are. So if you know who you are, other people look at you and they see who you are too. So just be your authentic self, man. Stick to your principles, man. Don't compromise. Stick to your principles. I always say compromise equals loss. If I want this cup of water and you want the cup of water, you say go ahead and get half of it, and we both lost. We still ain't get what we want. That's compromise. I mean, either way you look at it, it equals loss, because you're not getting what you want. But you at the stage of your life right now, you could get anything you want. You could have anything you want, and you could be anybody that you want to be. Trust me, I know. If I knew the things I knew now, I know we all heard that statement before, but it's true. You're not going to understand it or fully respect it until you get older and get some more experience under your belt. When you do, you'll understand these little cliches and these words and stuff that you heard. They real words, man, and they mean real things. They came from somewhere. People just ain't pulling this stuff out of the air. It came from somewhere. People have lived these lives, went through these experiences, and this is the conclusion that they came from. So when you listening to somebody that's older than you and they trying to take their time to give you some wisdom, or they trying to give you some knowledge, you should take that knowledge in. It ain't nothing that I know today, man, that I didn't learn from listening and just being attentive and being aware to my surroundings. Like I told you, I went into prison at 20. I ain't know nothing about prison. First time. Nothing. So I'm saying, so I had to listen. I had to learn, because my life depended on that. My survival depended on that. So that's how they do. It's like playing chess. Once you get in there, man, they knock the pieces over. They don't want to play no more, man. So you got to take advantage of being out here right now and the opportunities that's in front of you, man. Because making mistakes, man, only comes down to, like I say, making the right call at the right time. It's a dude named George Jackson. I used to do a lot of reading when I was in there. If you ever get a chance to read anything he wrote a book called Blood in My Eye. He wrote a book, George Jackson, Letters from Prison. Very articulate, intelligent man, self-taught, just like Malcolm X. But one of his sayings was that 85% of a man's sorrow in life is going to come from being self-imposed by failing to act and analyze in critical situations. 85% of everything that you go through bad, you could avoid by making the right decision, making the right choice. The other 15%, that's just life. It's going to happen anyway. You can't avoid that. But you can, you know, severely cut down your sorrow in life by just making the right decisions at the right time. And I'm telling you, man, I know y'all young, and I know a lot of y'all got a lot of testosterone, and you think you tough, and you feel like you can handle yourself in any situation. And I understand that. But let me tell you something, prison is a different world, man. It's a different world and different kind of animals in there. It ain't what you see on TV. And you get these dudes that go in there for a couple of years and they come out and they tell you, oh, it was like this, or I handled that, or bro, I did, like I say, 12,000 plus years and 12,000, 45 plus days in there. I ain't never have a good day in there. Never had a good day. Not one. I told your coach that today, not one good day. I had days that weren't as bad as other days, but I never had a good day. How you gonna have a good day? You ain't got your freedom. You eating like a dog. You living like an animal. You without everything that you love. That's the punishment of prison. You without everything that you love, everything that you care about, whatever it may be. Your cell phones, your girlfriend, you just waking up in the morning, going where you want to go, doing what you want to do. All that's eliminated. You on somebody else's time. You do what they say do, when they say do it, if they say do. I slept on a steel bed with a thin plastic mattress, plastic pillow for years, decades, you know, because that's the only option you got. That or the floor. That or the floor. We talking about the basketball team. You see how big your paint is? In the paint, the big man that play in the paint, that's how big my cell was. With two people in there, me and somebody else. I ain't got to like him and he ain't got to like me, but we got to share that space. That's life in prison. Anything anybody else tell you, it's a lie. I'm here, I'm the proof. I'm the proof. And you can die every day. Every day you step out that cell, death on the table. I don't care who you is or what you think you is. They got real gorillas in there who don't care nothing about you, me, or nobody else. Period. They wake up in the morning looking for somebody to kill if somebody wanted to die. That's just the reality of prison. You got dudes in there ain't never going home, don't even have a shot of going home. And you got some of them in there that don't care. They just don't care about anything. So your life means nothing to them. So you got to live around that every day, all day. And that's by choice. Because you put yourself in that situation. See what I'm saying? That's by choice. You got a better choice right now to when people come around you or you got bad influences around you or you know you hanging around with somebody that's on the wrong path that ain't trying to do what you trying to do. That ain't somebody you should be around, man. They making reservations for prison. That's what they doing. They making reservations for prison, whether they know it or not. I didn't know it. I was making reservations doing what I was doing. And just like I say in life, if you keep campaigning, you're going to get elected. You will get elected. You keep campaigning long enough, you'll get elected. And I'm telling you, bro, it just ain't no place for nobody. I wouldn't wish prison on my worst enemy. I wouldn't. And that's facts. I was talking to the coach today and I told him if I had to do it again, and I mean this sincerely, if they came to me and said, You got to do 33 years today or death. I take death, man. I take it. Because I can't do what I just did all over again. Because now I know what it takes to do that. All of my fortitude has been used, you know. I done used it all up to make it through the ordeal that I had to go through. So I couldn't do that again. And I don't want to see any one of y'all do that again. But trust and believe me, it only takes one moment, one incident. See, you get mad at somebody and the whole situation can change. See, I always say, don't do what you think. Think about what you're doing. Because 30 seconds of anger, 30 minutes later, you might not even be that mad. But that 30 seconds of anger can get you 30 years in prison. 30 years in prison. 30 seconds of anger. You could be mad as I don't know what, at something right now, and 30 minutes later you calm down and it don't even phase you no more. But if you act on that anger at that moment, you may do something that you can't never take back. You can't never take it back. Always remember this. I heard it. That's how I learned things. When I heard, I put it in my mind, and when it comes time to bring it back up or I heard something, I just regurgitated in my mind. That's how I learned. That's how I educated myself. That and reading. But when I heard something that's profound, I remember it. And I remember hearing this saying to say, anger, when you get mad, anger, the word anger, is always one letter away from danger. You put a D in front of anger, that's danger, bro. So every time you get mad, you in danger. You in danger of putting yourself in a bad position. You in danger of hurting somebody else. You in danger of hurting yourself. You in danger of just wiping your future out. So every time you get angry, you in trouble, bro. That's when you need to step back and think and ask yourself, assess the situation. Like George Jackson said, assess the situation, man, and make a good decision. Make a decision that's going to benefit you. Make a decision that's going to help you. If you ain't doing nothing or you ain't around nobody, man, that's moving in the direction in life that you moving in, then that ain't nobody you need to be around. That ain't nobody you need to be around. I don't care if they some kin to you. I don't care if they your best friend. I don't care if you grew up with them. It don't make no difference. If they ain't trying to do what you trying to do, they not for you. Because I said, the 33 years I spent in prison, I have never, not one time, went in the visiting room and seen all dudes in the visiting room. I never went in the visiting room and seen 80%, 60%, 50%, 30% dudes in the visiting room. It's always going to be your mama, your sister, your girl, your auntie. That's who coming to see you. That's who's supporting you when you in the lowest stage of your life. But them the same people that you ignoring when you out here and got your own free will. See what I'm saying? So you got to do the math to that stuff, man. You got to do the math to that. See, whoever you give your time to should be the people that you know that would give their time to you when you in need. Not somebody just because they cool. Not just somebody because they talking, man, because most of the time that's just what they doing, just talking. Just talk. I went to prison, man. I had a whole lot of friends. I was a popular dude, you know. I can count on these two fingers how many of them came to see me in 3 decades. But my mama always came to see me. My sister, you know, my aunties, you know, my nieces. That's just reality, man. That's just reality. So when you love something, man, love equals attention. If you love something, that's where your attention should be at. If you love your mom, if you love your sister, if you love the people that you know is trying to help you in life, that's where you should be spending your time. I ain't saying don't kick it with nobody. I'm just saying get your priorities in order. Get your priorities in order, man. Because when the stuff hit the fans, you know who gonna be there and who ain't. Like I say, just always think in your mind that 911 call. Who am I gonna call when I need some help? You know, who gonna get me a lawyer? Who gonna try to get me out of this situation? If it ain't one of them dudes you hang around with, then you already know the answer. So, man, that's what I want you to do. I just want you to get out of this message, man, to understand, man, that life is precious. There's a lot of things out here I see, and just these 500 and some days, man, it just blows my mind. It's things that y'all probably take for granted every day, But like I say, when you sitting in a cell every day and you looking at the same thing every day, I know y'all young, I don't know if y'all ever seen the movie Groundhog Day, but Groundhog Day, that's what prison is. You wake up every day, it's the same thing. So if you out here sometime and class get a little boring and this, and you think, oh man, it's so boring, and you want to go have some excitement and go do some other stuff, some foolish stuff that might put you at risk, man, you better think again. Prison is the kingdom of boredom. That's the kingdom of boredom and danger. That's what you're going to get every day, a dose of that every day in there. You know, you're going to do the same thing. You're going to wear the same thing. You're going to eat the same thing. You're going to go and move in a line every day the same thing. Nothing changes. Nothing. Now, if that sounds appealing to you, also, you know, might have to fight for your life at any time, then prison is the place for you. Because that's what's going on in there. That's reality. That's reality. So, man, like I say, you at a great stage in your life right now to do what you want to do, man. Don't get caught up on the talk. Don't get caught up on the hype, because all of that is, that's just talk, you know. And don't be faking it. Actors get paid. They get paid, man. Rappers get paid. They just talk. I know all y'all know who Lil Durk is. You know, Lil Durk got the song. He said, dudes claiming bodies they ain't do for real. He rapping. They ain't going to claim it in the courtroom. I can tell you that right now. When they go to court, they ain't gonna claim nobody. They gonna point straight at you. So, you know, them dudes get paid for talking. That's entertainment. They get paid for acting. Prison is real. That's real life. You go to prison for pretending. You get paid for acting. That's the difference. See what I'm saying? So, got to get your priorities in order. Understand, man, your life is precious, man. You at a great stage in your life right now, man. Y'all doing the right thing. You in college. You know what I'm saying? You in a place of higher learning. You trying to elevate and get your life where you want it to be. Everybody in here got dreams. Everybody in here got some type of vision of what you want to be 5 years from now, 10 years from now. So you got dreams and aspirations, and you in a good position to make all of that come true. But guess what? Everybody I know in prison got the same dream. Everybody got the same dream. That's to be in your position. To be out here, to be free, to get up when you want to, go do what you want. Change your mind at a moment's notice and you can go here. I'm going to store. No, I'm going. We can't do that in there. You can't. You're going to go more places and see more things and do more things in one day on the street than you would in decades in prison. That's a fact. And don't never get caught up with the illusion about you see dudes balling and they getting money and they looking like they having all this fun and all this, man. That's an illusion, bro. That's an illusion. Because whatever you get by ill-gotten means can be taken away from you in one second. You can ball out for 10 years, make 10 million. But if you don't get it the right way, then people can take it from you in 10 seconds. So you tell, where that add up at? Where that add up at? Everybody want to be successful, but you can't take the elevator to success, man. You got to take the stairs. One step at a time. One step at a time. It may take longer, but when you get there, can't nobody take it from you. Nobody can't take it from you, bro. What you earn, it, you know, success is greater when it's earned. They can't take it from you. So you got to keep that in mind, man. Don't get tricked off these streets. Don't get tricked out of your future. Don't get tricked out of your life. You got greatness in you, man. You know you got it in you. Don't nobody else know. You know it. I know you know. I know you wake up in the mirror. If you like me, I wake up and look in the mirror. I see greatness. I see greatness. See? And one of my biggest heroes in life was Muhammad Ali. Right? And I think his greatest attribute was that he believed in himself, self-belief. He was the king of it. He told you at 16, 15 years old, 13, I'm the greatest. And people looked at him and thought he was crazy. This little young fool, this little young kid, he crazy. But guess what? He went and made the world believe it. But he believed it first. See what I'm saying? You got to be your first cheerleader, your first motivator. If you believe it, you can make the world believe it. That's your job. If you say I'm great, you say I'm a king, and then you do kingly things and great things, and you do it on a consistent basis, then that's who you are. That's who you are. That's just fact. So, man, go out there, man, and make the world know you great, man. Make them know you great, man. I don't want to be remembered for doing 33 years in prison. I don't want my grandkids and kids to know that that's all I accomplished in life. You know, I could have simply came out here and been happy to be out here. But I feel like it's my job, it's my duty to tell y'all young brothers that, man, you can do better. Because when you know better, you can do better. Don't get tricked. Don't get fooled. Don't fall for the okey-doke, man. Your life is important. You out here, you free. Do your thing, man. Leave your footprint on this earth. Leave your footprint on this earth, man. Do what you want to do, man. Put that work in and everything else will fall into place, man. Do what you got to do right now and you'll be able to do what you want to do in your future, bro. I appreciate y'all for listening to me. Man, I salute y'all for staying on the right path, for being in college, being young kings and queens, man. Y'all will do great things in life, man. Just stay the course and don't never let nobody knock you off your path, man. Salute.